This is a time to start dual core project debugging. To start the dual core debug process with an STM32WL55 microcontroller, we need first to start a debug session for Cortex M4 core, then start its code execution, because as you remember, we are activating the Cortex M0 Plus core from the code of Cortex M4, and then we need to load additional debug session for ARM Cortex M0 Plus. Okay, we are ready to start a debug session on our board. The board is already connected by micro USB cable to PC. Within this exercise, I will use three buttons, B1, B2 and B3. B1 and B3 are assigned to Cortex M0 Plus, while the middle one, B2, is assigned to Cortex M4. Then we will use three LEDs, LED1, LED2 and LED3, which are as well distributed between both cores. So LED1 and LED3 are assigned to Cortex M4, while LED2 is assigned to Cortex M0 Plus. And as you remember, by pressing B1 or B2, we will switch on and off the middle ones, LED, so LED2, green one, while by pressing B2 button, which is assigned to Cortex M4, we will toggle both other LEDs, so green, blue and red one, so LED1 and LED3. Okay, to start our complete project, we need to first start a debug session for Cortex M4, just to release the core Cortex M0 Plus 1. This is within this line of Cortex M4 project. And within this debug session, we will load, in fact, binaries for both cores. So for Cortex M4 and Cortex M0 Plus. And within second round, we will load additional debug session for Cortex M0 Plus, just to load symbols which would be necessary to debug both applications. We are using as well some global variables which we will monitor within live expressions. So for Cortex M4, it would be var_cm4 initialized by 0 at the beginning, and for Cortex M0 Plus we will have a similar one. It will be var_cm0p initialized with 0 as well. Okay, so I'm starting first Cortex M4 debug session. So I go to this debug icon, down arrow, debug configurations, and I select CM4 debug. Okay. And I can start this code. In fact, I started code on both cores. After this line, Cortex M0 Plus is starting execution of its code as well. I will switch to this live expression. I already, let's say, put the values over here. You can add new ones by pressing this plus and typing the variable name. As you can see, this is core agnostic, so I've got variables here from both cores. As right now the active debug session is for Cortex M4, I can see the increased values of this variable, and Cortex M0 plus 1 is unknown because it is not an active debug session for Cortex M0 plus. The next step would be to load symbols for Cortex M0 Plus, so start its debug session. We already loaded the code within this Cortex M4 one, so it would be only loading symbols for the debug. So I go to this bug icon, down arrow, debug configurations, and I select Cortex M0 Plus and press debug. As you remember, within the configuration for this debug session, we have disabled reset during the connection, so it is not intrusive way, it is not stopping, it is not resetting the cores. It is just loading additional symbols related to Cortex-M0 Plus code execution. As you can see, now we are in, within this Cortex-M0 Plus debug configuration as active one. This is why we can see the variable related to Cortex-M0 Plus increasing. And now I can switch between them. So now I'm, let's say, at Cortex-M4, now within Cortex-M0 Plus. I can suspend both cores at the same time using this suspend button. So I press it and now you can see that both cores are suspended. And if I would switch between them, you can see the variable is not increasing on both sides. I can resume the code execution on both cores at the same time synchronously, but now it is a bit more tricky. I need to press a control button on the keyboard and select both threads related to both cores. And now, as I've got selected both of them, I press resume. And now you can see that the core Cortex-M0 Plus and M4 is running one and the second one. Okay, so this is how we can synchronously suspend and resume code execution. I've got some breakpoints on both cores within the external interrupts. So this is for Cortex M0 Plus, and as you can see, for both buttons, and for Cortex M4 it is very similar. I put the breakpoint as well within the external interrupt callback. So right now I'm the active core. The active debug session, the highlighted one is a Cortex M4. So now I would try to stop on the breakpoint by, let's say, executing the interrupt on Cortex M4 as well. So I'm clicking the middle button. And as you can see, I landed within the external interrupt callback. This interrupt, I can try to resume both operations. So again, I press the control button and I select both cores. As you can see, both are suspended by the breakpoint, as we configured the CTI interface within the debug configurations for both. And I press resume, and you can see both cores are resumed, and we can see two LEDs assigned to Cortex M4 which has changed the state. So we can see blue and red. So blue and red LED turned on. We can repeat this exercise being within the Cortex M0 perspective. So right now I would press button B1. So as we can see, both cores are suspended as well. I am here within the callback of Cortex M0 Plus, and I can do the same exercise. So pressing Ctrl, I'm selecting both threads for Cortex M0 and Cortex M0 Plus, and I'm resuming code execution. And as you can see, I'm landing immediately within frequently used interrupt from SysTick on Cortex M4, so I need to resume it once again. This is due to the fact that there is no full support on CTI peripheral within the current GDB implementation on this tool. It will be added in future revisions. What we can see here as well, we can monitor, of course, the registers for both microcontrollers. So within STM32CubeIDE, this is within these SFRs section, so special function register. So right now, as we are within the Cortex M4, we can see the Cortex M4 peripherals. If I would switch to Cortex M0, I would land within the Cortex M0 peripherals. So we can monitor the content of the registers as well as, let's say, we've got the complete symbols map loaded for both cores. To stop synchronously both cores, so to terminate the session, I can select as well both by pressing the control button and click on this terminate. So both sessions will be finished, and we will come back to C++ perspective, where we can continue the coding. Let's do a short summary of this part activities. Okay, a bit more information you can find within the application note AN5564, getting started with projects based on dual core STM32WL microcontrollers using STM32CubeIDE. Thank you for your attention.